Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today let's talk about when not to use AI or ML in your products. First, I know these two buzzwords right now make products look sexy, and while every other startup in 21st century uses these terms while explaining their next innovation, is it actually required in every scenario? Well, in order to know when not to use ML or AI, let's first see when you should actually use them. Number one, when we want to find a useful pattern. Yes, if you need to discover a pattern between dependent variable and an independent variable, and if we could find it, it would not just make our product better, but also could help us explore more brighter and newer side of the program we are building. Number two, when we want to generalize the established pattern. If you are someone who's working in data science industry, you'll soon realize that it's not enough to establish a pattern in our data. To say the truth, it's quite easy to establish a pattern. The challenge comes when you want to make your established pattern into a generalized one. Confused? Well, a generalized pattern is the one which stays relevant even when certain scenarios or conditions are over. And it's quite hard to confess that all patterns are not generalized in nature when it comes to machine learning. As a reminder, I would like to reinforce the fact that finding patterns and using them is what machine learning or AI is all about. And it is our job to look for better patterns that help us move forward and make progress with the available data. Now, I believe that you have some background on when machine learning or AI is generally employed. Next, let's take up scenarios when we should not use AI or machine learning. Number one, when there's no pattern to connect input with output. Now you might be thinking, is there any such thing like this? Well, yes. One such example would be to calculate how human brain develops a feeling called love. I know what faces you are making right now, but you cannot correlate factors and tell a machine why humans love their pet or siblings or someone they just met at workplace. Number two, when you lack good data. We all know that machine learning algorithms require a large amount of data before they even begin to give useful results. The larger the architecture, the more data is required to produce viable results. And while you might try to pull in every data that you can find on the web, not all of that might be useful to you or can be applied to your business use case, and can even cause your algorithm to perform poorly. Also, do note that reusing data is also a bad idea, and data augmentation is useful to some extent only. Though having more data is always a preferred solution, having good data is something that should be a priority. By good here, I mean data which can directly affect the end result of your model. Number three, when we are dealing with non-stationary universes. This translates to a situation when all the data that you have isn't relevant anymore, perhaps because a pandemic like COVID-19 changed the rules. It won't matter how good is the information that you have, as it is all irrelevant now. If you want to build a machine learning model, you need to prepare data as per the new rules. Simply because if your past data all of a sudden don't apply to all the non-stationary future which you're having, you are not allowed to use yesterday to predict tomorrow with a straight face. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, be sure to smash that like button. And if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.